Human Biosciences, and I'm a spokesperson for the Public Health Association of Australia about the TPP, and I'm here in Singapore representing the Public Health Association of Australia. And the Public Health Association's been concerned for a number of years now about the Trans-Pacific Partnership Agreement and the effect that it could have on the health systems of Australia and the other countries in the TPP. So I'm just going to run through some of those concerns, and I'm going to spend most of my time focusing on a part of the TPP that hasn't had very much attention recently, which is the Healthcare Transparency Annex, which is a part of the TPP. It's an annex to the Transparency Chapter, and the US is trying to use that annex to impose constraints on pharmaceutical coverage programs in the TPP countries, particularly Australia and New Zealand. So I'll talk a bit about some of the risks to healthcare in the agreement in terms of access to affordable medicines. Men has already talked a bit about intellectual property. I'll run through that very quickly. And the provisions in the Healthcare Transparency Annex about pharmaceutical pricing and reimbursement. We're also concerned about rules that apply to state-owned enterprises and the effect that might have on our public hospitals. And also the risks to public health regulation and legislation in a whole lot of different areas. That in public health, we would want to see government regulating more strongly in terms of products that harm health, like tobacco, food labelling and alcohol. So at a time where we're seeing a rise in non-communicable diseases all around the world, we'd want to see governments taking a stronger role in regulating health damaging products, and the TPP will prevent that. For the intellectual property chapter, the US has proposed a whole suite of provisions that would extend and expand patent monopolies and delay the access of affordable generic medicines. So there are a number of different avenues by which the IP chapter would do this. I won't go into them because we've been talking about those already. But together, these would delay the access to affordable medicines, and this would have the most effect on the developing countries involved in the agreement. And even in wealthy countries like Australia, it would be people who are on low incomes, people like pensioners, elderly people, people who have chronic illnesses and who are on multiple medications who would suffer the most from the rising cost of medicine. So we'd see the duration of patents extended. We'd see medical procedures being patented. We'd see patents more difficult to challenge. And we'd see higher costs for governments and health services and consumers. So it would be the most vulnerable people in the TPP countries who would be most affected by this. Now, as I mentioned, the US has proposed a healthcare transparency annex that imposes new disciplines on pharmaceutical pricing and reimbursement in the TPP countries. So this includes provisions that would prevent therapeutic reference pricing, which is a really important strategy that countries like Australia and New Zealand use to keep the cost of pharmaceuticals down. So this is a strategy that links the cost of new drugs to existing drugs that are already available for the same condition. So a new drug will only get a higher price if it's actually more effective in treating that condition. The US also wants an independent appeals process for pharmaceutical companies to challenge recommendations for medicines listing and pricing. In Australia at the moment, we have a limited independent review process that can only result in a reconsideration of a decision by our advisory committee about whether to list a drug for reimbursement or not. But this appeals process would enable any decision, any recommendation about listing or pricing to potentially be overturned. As well as these requirements, there are also a whole lot of different obligations for disclosure of information about decision making, and what the pharmaceutical industry likes to call transparency, which is really about giving the pharmaceutical industry more levers to challenge the decision making. The US also wants to see mandatory direct consumer advertising of pharmaceuticals via the internet, and this is a practice that is prohibited in most of the TPP countries. Only the US and New Zealand currently permit medicines to be directly advertised to consumers. The reason why many of the countries prohibit this is because it can lead to over-prescribing of pharmaceuticals, and it can raise pharmaceutical expenditure. So of the TPP countries, Australia and New Zealand are most at risk from this healthcare transparency annex. If Taiwan were to join the agreement, and Taiwan has indicated that it's interested, Taiwan's program of pharmaceutical benefits associated with its national health insurance scheme would also be at risk. But the pharmaceutical price controls in other countries may also be at risk. It depends on what the wording actually is in the annex. So what this annex would mean for the TPP countries is reduced control over medicines policy, new avenues for the pharmaceutical industry to influence decision making, higher costs to governments and consumers, or governments might manage these costs by restricting access to drugs, and the sustainability of health systems would be threatened. The amount of money that governments spend on pharmaceuticals is often a very high proportion of the health expenditure in countries, and if this goes up, it means there's less money available for other essential health services. But the most outrageous thing about this healthcare transparency annex is that the US is seeking to carve out its own drug programs. So it wants to impose new restrictions on the drug programs of other countries, but leave its own drug programs intact. Of course, all the other countries have been quite unhappy about this, and the US proposals for this annex have been rejected so far in the negotiations. But it's very concerning that we've got to this final stage of negotiations and no decisions have been made about this annex. So my concern is that at this final stage, when the countries are bargaining about different issues, that they may accept this transparency annex in exchange for market access or other concessions from the US. So this is a real risk in the next few days. I've probably used up most of my time, but I'll just mention quickly some of our other concerns. With the state-owned enterprise chapter, the intention of this chapter seems to be to ensure that state-owned enterprises don't receive unfair advantages. It's not clear whether all health services would be excluded from this chapter. So this could affect the operation of public health services like public hospitals, particularly those public health services that engage in some private or commercial activities. We're also concerned about how the TPP might tie the hands of governments in their efforts to regulate health damaging products, increase opportunities for industry input into policy making, give corporations more opportunities to make complaints, for example, and we're particularly concerned about the investor state dispute settlement mechanism, which would give companies more opportunities to challenge public health decision making. Other speakers will talk about tobacco control and tobacco plain packaging. We're very concerned about our tobacco plain packaging laws. In Australia, we already have Philip Morris Asia suing us in an international tribunal over these laws. The TPP would give the tobacco companies another opportunity to do that. We're also concerned about an annex to the technical barriers for trade chapter of the TPP that might place restrictions on alcohol health warnings. Australia and New Zealand are both considering requiring the alcohol industry to put pregnancy warnings on alcohol bottles. We're concerned that rules in this annex might give alcohol manufacturers the right to put information on a supplementary label on an alcohol bottle. So instead of governments being able to say a health warning should go on the main front or back label on the alcohol bottle, manufacturers may be able to put the health warning on an extra label on the side or the top or the bottom of the bottle, instead of the most prominent position where we would want to see that displayed. We're concerned that the processed food industry might have more opportunities to challenge decisions of governments about food labelling and things like that. And we're concerned about increased foreign investment in the TPP countries, leading to greater penetration of processed foods into many of the countries. And I think I'll finish up there. And just my contact details, and I'm in Singapore until Tuesday night and available for interviews. Thanks very much.
Thank you very much, Deborah. We'll move on to the next speaker, Dr. Mary Asunta.